stock car racing program than any other racetrack around, and you're one of them. remind you that next Friday, actually not next Friday, it's coming.
Package MRS Mechanical Services Pontiac, the number 55 is Dwight Jarvis, the number 47 Johnny Lobo Jr., and the number 61 for David Pinkham. The green is out. Leading him down the back stretch is Ted Brown, who ran very impressively last week and is showing the same kind of stuff this week as he comes around to lead lap number one. Bruce D'Alessandro slipping into second. Doug Rudolph getting stuck up on the high side of the track, and he may just lose position number three to Jerry Marquis as he's battling back on the outside, but the inside group seems to work for Marquis, and he moves into third. Rudolph coming across the line in fourth with Dwight Jarvis running in the fifth spot. Three laps showing on the Winston Racing Series scoreboard. It's still Ted Brown on top. Bruce D'Alessandro running second. Jerry Marquis third. Dwight Jarvis fourth. Doug Rudolph fifth. And Rusty Ball's got the sixth spot. Running order as Ted Brown shows the rest of the field a quick way around the high bank quarter mile oval. Doug Rudolph makes a move on the inside of Dwight Jarvis. The battle is on for fourth. Jerry Marquis sees time running out. He'd like to move up a spot himself. Doug Rudolph takes the third, the fourth position away from Dwight Jarvis, and Jerry Marquis, it looks like he's got the second spot away from Bruce D'Alessandro. Eight laps down, four to go. The battle is on for the third spot as Doug Rudolph got the inside groove on Bruce D'Alessandro. And at the line, Rudolph has claimed the third position on that lap. Marquis heads to the outside. Two laps to go, and the battle's on for the lead position. Coming off of turn number two, we've got a new race leader, it's Jerry Marquis. White flag, one lap to go. Rudolph dives low underneath Brown. Brown holds him off as they headed into turn number one. Here's the checkered flag, your winner, it is Jerry Marquis. The number three, Mike Duquette, and rounding out the field is the number three of Brian Kenyon. No starts this time around, as we still stay under yellow conditions. Green is out this time. Brett Rollins comes to the outside of Robin Mowry as he complete one lap. It's Robin Mowry coming across the line in receiver. Brett Rollins running second, Robin up third. Monkey Carradine moves into fourth with Bill Burrows in the fifth position. We got a spin over in turn number four. It's Brian Kenyon. Kenyon gets straightened out. We still stand to green. But unfortunately, Brett Rollins gets in behind as he's slow moving. be number three car. That has cost him a couple of positions on the racetrack. Rob Winnenhoff moves into the second spot, but here comes Punky Karen on the outside of the 121. He is challenging side by side with Rob Winnenhoff on lap number three. Karen moves into the second spot as they go into turns three and four. Rob Winnenhoff giving up the position to Karen. Karen's got second. He wants to go one better as he goes to the high side of Robin Mowry. Overhauls Mowry on the backstretch at the halfway point. Six laps down, six to go. Rob Winnenhoff moves in the second spot. Here comes Brett Rollins sliding back on the outside. Rollins with the advantage, and he clearly takes the third position, followed very closely by Jim Bonifay, who moves to the fourth. Eight laps down, four to go. It's Karen still in the lead. Rob Winnenhoff runs second. Jim Boniface takes the third position away from Rollins on the backstretch. We have a spin over in turn number two. Let's see if we go to yellow. Indeed, we do. On the racetrack, we'll look for a green this time around, and indeed, Billy Dunn gives the field a green. Monkey Karen holding on to the top spot. Jim Boniface has taken back the third position from Brett Rollins. This time around, two laps to go. It's Karen. Good enough. Checkered flag, your winner, Punky Karen. The number 29 junior, and that is Eddie Brio Jr. of Baldwinville. Three rows back will be the number 5 car, and that is the number 5 for John Corliss of Winchester, New Hampshire. Now the entire number 4, a late arrival to the speedway, and unfortunately we do not have the driver's name as of yet. The green is out. And Roger Raymond wasting no time putting the Ford in the lead, but we have a yellow. So false start. Now we stand the green as the number 29 car. Thought the yellow was going to come out for car number 29, but it did not. And he has been black flagged. And he is off of the pace, so he can stay under green. Roger Raymond on top. Jerry Marquis runs second. Gary Knight, Jr., third. Ryan Corliss has got the fourth. The fourth position, Knight Gamalini moves into the top five with car number 66. Definite handling problem in Camaro entry number 66, and he gives up the fifth spot to Ron Aldridge Jr. Jerry Marquis is right on the back bumper of Roger Raymond, and we will see some action developing between those two veteran competitors. We are up to the halfway point as Marquis dives low, coming off of turn number 4. He is under Roger Raymond, and going into turn number 1, he takes the position away. Jerry Marquis comes around to lead lap number 7. Roger Raymond runs second. Gary Knight Jr. running a nice steady race in the third spot. moved into the fifth position. Stretching out his lead over Roger Raymond.
J.T. Thompson, the number 18, Gary Fioramonte, car number 11 for John Ledger, and rounding out the field of 113 for Skip Hockwright. Green is out. Good battle down the backstretch between Tim Creamer and Jeff Beckwith, and they're side by side off of turn number 4. Let's see who gets the advantage at the line. Slight advantage goes to Jeff Beckwith, who leads lap number 1. Beckwith way up high in the backstretch, but he uses that high groove to still hold on to the lead position. Tim Creamer runs second, Mike Parks third. Here comes Tom Carey Jr. Carey battling side by side with Mike Parks. Rookie driver Mike Parks showing plenty of talent in holding off Tom Carey Jr. for yet another lap. Carey pedals to the floorboard, takes the third position away from Parks. Parks fights back. Contact is made between turns 3 and 4. And Parks has a flat right front tire. Tough break for that fine youngster. Beckwith still on top, Tim Creamer runs second, Tom Carey Jr. third, Bill Breed fourth, Barry Smokey Gray in for the fifth position. Al Fitzgerald runs in the sixth position, and Nipper Alsop's got seventh. We got a spin on the backstretch. J.T. Thompson goes around in car number 97. At the trackside booth, and he'll be signing autographs for you. So come on down and meet Jerry Marquis, one of the front runners in modified and pro stock competition here at Monadnock Speedway. Please, let's have a nice orderly line. Jerry will be around to sign autographs. Let's have a nice orderly line, and he will gladly sign an autograph and talk to you about racing. Meanwhile, back at the race here, it is still Jeff Beckwith on top, but Tom Carey Jr. and Barry Gray have moved in very quickly to challenge for the top position. We have problems over in turn number 2 as Gary Fioramonte has a flat left front tire bringing out the yellow flag. Gary trying to get out of the way. Give Gary some credit there. He tried to make it back down pit road so that the yellow flag would not be brought out. Okay, if you didn't hear the announcement just made, Jerry Marquis pass in the eighth position. Woodstock driver Nipper Alsop, and rounding out the field, John Ledger from Southbridge, Mass. Green is out. Beckwith off to a squirrely start, and we've got trouble over in turns 1 and 2. The yellow comes out. a drag race with Bill Breed at turn number one. He stays on top. Bipper Alsup and Skip Hockright having a battle for position number four, with Alsup nipping him at the line to take the fourth position. Hockright fights back on the outside. He's smoking the tires going down the backstretch. Two laps to go for Carey. Hockright way up high off of turn number four, and that gives him a little bit of a problem as he's given up two positions. One lap for Carey on his way to victory. Checkered flag, your winner, Tom Carey Jr. In Massachusetts, of Gardner, Massachusetts, driver John Meany. Rounding out the field, number 28 car, the car usually piloted by Ted Chalmers. Ted unable to drive the car this evening because of injuries sustained at Riverside Park last Saturday. Taking over the driving duties of that car is Bob Pinky Payan of Holyoke, Massachusetts. Jerry Marquis' autograph, there's still time for you to do it at the trackside table behind the grandstand and in front of the announcer's tower. Green is out. Gainer leading the field on the backstretch. Tom Hebert running second. Dave Sutherland Jr. third. Rob Cross and Kevin Livingooder dicing it out for fourth. Number 16 way up high, and he spins into the dirt on turn number four. Yellow flag comes out. Billy Dunn stares the field down, likes what he sees, the green is out. Dave Gainer and Tom Hebert are battling for the number one spot, as are Dave Sutherland and Rob Cross for the third position. Gainer comes off turn four and he leaves lap number two. Hebert in second, Cross coming on strong on the inside. Rob Cross covers Hebert on the inside. Hebert must stay committed to the outside. He is way, way up high on the back stretch, and he gives up the spot to Cross. Ed Stone moving into fourth. Halfway point this time around. Your running order at the halfway point is Gainer, Cross, Stone, Hebert, Sutherland, and Meany. Cross heads to the outside. Gainer hanging in top. Gainer up, and he has taken over the lead position as they go through turns one and two and down the backstretch. So Cross, your leader, with two laps to go, and Stone is taking the second spot at the line with Gainer in third, Hebert fourth. One lap to go for Cross. Waves for your winner, Rob Cross.
Bill Gunter, the one junior, Jim LaFortune Jr., Sonny Robinson and Mike Murray round out the field. We've got a green. In at turn number one, Fowler and McGoy race side by side for the number one spot. Off turn number four, we've got trouble as Al Holtz goes around at number 71. However, he's able to get retired, so it looks as if we'll stand the green. Dale LaVoy goes off into the early race lead. We've got more trouble over in turn number four, as the 03 of Wetzel gets sideways, full wide down the front straightaway. A wild field of mini stocks as we've got a car over in the pit wall. Yellow flag is out. Also, Lauren Lorenzetti is parked on the front straightaway. We've got a mess out there. The 44 of Beef Alexander goes. Green is out. Dale LaVoy goes back off into the lead. Art Goodheimer on second. Pappy Fowler's third. Allen on Abby fourth. Trouble on the back straightaway. Bill Gunter goes around with the number 21. Yellow flag is back out. Straightaway they go, looking for the green. LaVoy, Crowell, and Goodhide. Here they come. Green flag is out. Dale LaVoy continues to lead this field. Art Goodhide runs second. Trouble off turn number two. Big Jim LaFortune goes around to car number one. However, he's able to keep the car fired up and will stay on the green. Dark behind down back straightaway. Pappy Crowell and Alan Anacki battle it out for the second spot. Make that third. Kirk Alexander runs fifth. Rick DeRozier is sixth. Wenzel is seventh. Bill Goodell running a fine race. Now in eighth in the 14. We're coming around now for the completion of five laps. Gail LaVoy is holding off Art Goodheim. Alan Anacki has moved into third. Fourth is Pappy Crowell, but he's being pressured by Kirk Alexander on the outside. Alexander picks up the fourth spot. Pappy Crowell falls to fifth. Three-car battle for the lead as they come off turn number four. Contact is made between Goodheim and Anacki. Anacki takes over the second spot. Now Anacki heads to the outside of LaVoy. A little bit of contact between those two as they come off turn number four. LaVoy continues to lead. However, Alan Anacki begins to come on strong, way up high off turn number two. Here comes Kirk Alexander in the 44F. Trouble off turn number four. Mike Marion goes around at the double zero. Yellow flag is out. However, Marion is able to pull back out onto the racing surface, and yellow is out. Field loose. Here they come into turns three and four. Gail LaVoy is going to have her hands full because Alan Anacki is looking strong. Green flag is out. LaVoy leads them down into turn number one. Anacki runs second. Goodheim is third. Kirk Alexander is fourth. And here comes Wenzel. He's got the fifth spot. Anacki heads to the outside of Gail LaVoy to battle for the number one spot. Off turn number four, LaVoy continues to hold them off. Trouble over in turn number three. Gunter goes around in car number 21. He pulls off the racing surface. Anacki gets the advantage as they head into turn number three. And brand new leader off turn four, car number four, Alan Anacki. LaVoy falls to second, but is still holding on down on the inside. Goodhart is third. Kirk Alexander is fourth. Fifth is Wenzel. Sixth is Pappy Crowell. Seventh is Goodell. Eighth is Pete Alexander. Ninth is Hanson. And running in the fifth spot, the one New Hampshire of Kevin Green. Car number 71, Al Holmes, is one lap down. Mike Alexander all hooked up in a good battle for the second spot. This time by, three to go, and Alan Anapi is looking for his first feature event win of the 1990 racing season. Yellow Boy runs second. Kirk Alexander has found his way into the third spot. He now heads to the outside of LaVoy, and just like that, Kirk Alexander becomes your new second place runner in Carnival 44X. LaVoy, however, continuing to fight back, but Alexander pulls away with the 44. Wetzel has moved into fourth. Fifth is Goodhide. White flag is up for Alan Anacki. After number four, Wetzel gets way up high. Trouble over in turn number three. We go to a yellow checkered situation. Alan Anacki takes down the win. Second goes to Kirk Alexander, and third to Gail LaVoy in car number 66.
As soon as we get the photos taken care of, Alan, come on over here. Alan, congratulations. Second feature event win in the year. You came from pretty deep in the pack. The car was running very, very well once again. You won it kind of handily.
Thank you. Had our ups and downs. Today was an up.
Well, indeed, it's always good to end up finding your way to victory lane. Congratulations on that win. Nice round of applause for your winner, Alan Anacki, with car number four, second feature event win of the season. Second place going to number 44X of Kirk Alexander in third position. She led most of it as the little lady, Gail LaVoy. Okay, we're going to go back up to the flag stand for a special presentation. Slowly but surely move down the back stretch. They'll be starting to get on it right now. And the green is out. And the inside lane gets the advantage with Robin Maury breaking out on top. Is at the start finish line. The number 12 car goes around. The yellow flag comes out as we've got three cars in the infield area, not too far off of the racing surface. One of those cars being the New England Brake and Muffler Texas engine. This is number 12 of Brett Rollins. Green, and there it is. Roger Raymond powers his way into the lead with a Ford-powered Thunderbird. Jim Boniface goes around, and he is in turn hit by the number three car. And Mike Ramolini suffers extensive damage, sheet metal damage, actually fiberglass damage, to his number 66. Yellow is back out. Machine being pushed into the infield. Apparently a clutch problem on a number 32X. Clutch or transmission, one or the other. And they begin to stand on it. Billy Dunn gives them the green. Roger Raymond picking up where he left off in the lead position. Robin Maury holding down the second spot. Here comes Punky Karen with a number 121.
Monkey bears down hard down the front chute, and he's got the second spot away from Maury. Karen really flying this evening. And he has quickly closed in on the back bumper to Stewart & Sons Ford number 62. We have a spin over in turn number two. We've got an engine going on the number three D car in turns three and four. So the race's only Chrysler powered car goes up in a puff of smoke. How about Jerry Marquis? Well, we shall see very shortly as the green is out. Raymond with the advantage. Punky Karen dives low down the backstretch. He put a fender underneath the Ford, and Raymond is sliding and dirt and tracking it right off of turn number four and gives up the lead position to Karen. Punky Karen, your race leader, Roger Raymond runs second. Rob Goodenough's got third. Jerry Marquis up to fourth. Robin Maury drop kick back to fifth. Two cars go around in turns three and four. Ryan Kenyon able to continue, and Corliss is struggling to get into the infield, but he cannot do it. Yellow flag is out. So back under caution we go. Edge on this restart. Green is out, and it's Karen with Raymond getting a tap from Goodenough, but Raymond holding on to the second spot. Jerry Marquis moves into third as Goodenough having a bit of a problem on that restart and on the rest of that lap. Goodenough has settled down into the fourth spot. Jeff Zideman makes his move on the outside of Robin Maury, and Zideman slips into the top five. Marquis moves up to challenge Roger Raymond for second. Marquis takes a peek to the outside. Jim Boniface moves into position number six. Karen, very impressively leading the field as Marquis is still working on the inside of Roger Raymond. And contact is made just enough for a bobble on the part of Raymond, and the second spot goes to Marquis. Set his sights on the Punky Karen number 121. Marquis, with each and every passing lap, seems to be cutting that lead down. Traffic coming within sight of Punky Karen. Punky will have to pick his moves. With those slower cars, and Jerry Marquis is closed in on the back bumper of the number 121. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have a race on our hands. Halfway point upon us. 18 laps down, 17 to go. Phillips is still Funky Karen on top, Jerry Marquis second, Roger Raymond third, Rob Goodenough running strong in the fourth spot, Jeff Zydema fifth. Zydema and Boniface make a little contact and they're battling for the fifth position. Zydema managing to hold on. Between turns 3 and 4 in the number 27 car. Also spinning into the infield, the number 5 car, John Corliss. The number 66 car, which has been black flagged for numerous laps, has now been ordered to go in the pit area as more fiberglass coming off of the front end of the number 66, this time the right front fender peeling back. The infield will be looking for a green, and there it is. Well, they will pick it up where they left it off, and these two gentlemen have had quite a few good battles between themselves already this season, Funky Karen and Jerry Marquis. Junior drops off the pace. We've got a spin over in turns 1 and 2. It is the number 43 car of Dave Prime in the Gibson Golden Value Appliance Firebird. And we're back under green. Still spinning into the infield off of turn number 4. Number 4 comes back up, and 17 Mass is just sitting there. And that necessitates another yellow flag. Brian Kenyon. Well, folks, we made it off of lap number 27, but we didn't get very far. We only punched in one more lap on the Winston Racing Series scoreboard. We're up to 28 laps. Got a lot of orders for new fenders, hoods, and whatnot. Green is out. Trying every which way to get by, but Karen has risen to the occasion every lap. Marquis dives low. Karen still with enough power off the turn to be able to hold off any of those inside advances from Marquis. Roger Raymond is up there, now it's a three-car race. To go this time around, Dave Prime drops off the pace. Roger Raymond goes the outside of Marquis. White flag, final lap. Punky Carrot holds on for the win.
Position tonight, taking down yet another victory this season with the 121. Jerry Marquis comes in second in the 28X, and third to car number 62 for Roger Raymond. Momentarily, John Berry will be going trackside with our winner, Punky Karen.
Applause for your winner, Punky Karen of Goshen, New Hampshire.
Rudolph
Archery number 4, he moves into the third position. Toots Brown on top, Ball second, Monty third, looking to right, Jarvis, the defending champ is all the way up in the fourth, that quickly. Here comes Jerry Marquis with a BT-73. Rusty Ball looks for racing room on the outside of Ted Brown. He pulls up side by side. They're tire to tire coming off of train four. It's Brown still on top, but Ball is coming on strong. Ball edges out ahead as they get on the backstretch. And Rusty Ball looks like he's going to take the lead. Indeed he does as they come off of train number four. Kirby Monty follows suit on the outside. Jerry Marquis moves swiftly into the third position. D'Alessandro comes to life on the outside. Kirby Monteith got second. Monteith goes to work on Ball. He tried to move on the inside. Ball held him off. Rusty Ball putting a little bit of daylight between himself and Monteith. He's got about a one-car length lead. Looking to stretch it out even further, but Monteith is very strong off the turn. Marquis dives low. Monteith with enough power to hold him off. Good racing action so far. Rusty Ball in the lead position. Monteith second, Marquis third. D'Alessandro has moved into the fourth position with Jarvis rounding out the top five. Monteith trying to fight off Marquis. Marquis relentless on the inside. And Marquis moves into second. Monteith comes back on the outside. Monteith is not going to give up that position easily. And Ball is being challenged by Marquis. And Marquis makes the move on the inside pay off. And he's got the lead coming off of turn number two. Jarvis fifth. The number 61 car in trouble. We've got a spin on the backstretch. And it's the number 85 car of Kirby Monteith spinning in the backstretch. The number 61 car of David Pinkham. Apparently with a problem stalling out. Number 90 heads down to the pit area, and Maroka in row number 3. Rain is out. Marquis off to a strong start. And he holds down the position number 1 as they go down the backstretch. Halfway point upon us, 17 laps down, 18 to go. Turn four, he spins into the infield. A couple other cars spinning to try to avoid making contact with the Principe machine. They'll start to pick up the pace as they approach the Winston Racing Series scoreboard. And the green is out. Dwight Jarvis gets the advantage, but we've got a couple of cars bumper hooked. And it's Doug Rudolph and Ted Brown that have managed to get hooked up for bringing out a yellow flag. Dwight Jarvis made good on that restart, but he's going to go back as we weren't able to complete that lap as Kirby Monteith is in the lab. And the two cars, Dunk Rudolph and Ted Brown, are locked up at each other's bumpers. Second of weeks, he was relishing victory in victory lane last week. And now taking a trip back to the pit area on the business end of a tow truck. Well, I guess that's the way auto racing is. Things can change very, very quickly in this sport. Well, the L&L tow trucks have managed to separate. And a 61 of David Pinkham running fifth. Still staying under yellow. Bodreau goes to the outside of David Pinkham. The battle is on for the third spot coming off of turn four. D'Alessandro way up high again. He loses valuable time. Two laps to go. Jarvis has just two laps to go in his bid to overhaul Marquis off of the front spot. Comes off for Marquis as D'Alessandro gives it one final bid on David Pinkham. D'Alessandro, he is up high and he is sliding around and spins into the infield. Checkered flag comes out. The win goes to Jerry Marquis.
Second in the Pro Stock feature event, and even better, taking down the win in the 35-lap modified feature event. Second goes to Dwight Jarvis in third, a 5-1 for Saco main driver, Conover 61, David Pinkham. Momentarily, John Berry will be going trackside with your winner, Jerry Marquis.
Out of the number 73 car, as he picked up another feature event win here at Monadnock Speedway. Well, Jerry is out of the car. Very, very happy. Jerry Marquis wins the feature event here at Monadnock Speedway. Congratulations, Jerry. You really had to work for that one, as there was a lot of yellow flags that came out. It looks like it's taking its toll on you because you seem to be sweating quite profusely. And, well, another feature event win comes your way.
Yeah, the car is really working real well here tonight. I'd like to thank Precision Automotive. They've been really helping us a lot with the motor. Hoosier Tires have been giving us a hookup, and the guys have been doing a super job maintaining the car. I'd like to thank our sponsors, MRS, Standard Plumbing Supply, and all the other people, Stop and Start Transmission, and everybody that's been helping us out. I'd like to really thank them. They've been doing a super good job this year. And I'd like to thank everybody for coming out and watching us race here. We appreciate it, and we love the fans. Thank you.
And Jerry, I'd like to thank you very much for coming out to pit area and signing autographs for the fans and talk with them about racing. We really do appreciate that, don't we, fans? Okay, our second place finisher was Dwight Jarvis in car number 55, our defending Winston Racing Series champion. And our third place finisher making a very impressive outing and only a second time out here on the high banks is David Pinkham from Saco, Maine with the Coors number 61. Now, Jerry, don't go too far because we're going to have you take care of the 50-50 raffle for us. Position. Harry goes to the outside of Fitzgerald. hammered down, but on a back stretch, and Carey is flying on the outside. Carey makes quick work of Dave Sutherland Jr. He's got the second spot. The only obstacle in the way of Tom Carey Jr. and another victory here at Monadnock Speedway is the number six Vermont, the black machine of Steve Gaynor. Carey begins to take the measure of Gaynor. He's got it closed up to a half a car length. Carey takes a look at the outside. Gaynor still holding on that top spot, but here comes Carey. Carey powers his way down the back stretch, and he's got the lead. So lap number eight. The lead change between a Steve Gaynor and a Tom Carey Jr. with Carey on top. Yellow flag is out as we have a multi-car incident in turns three and four. Cars involved, the number five Vermont of Rob Cross, the number 28 a Pinky Pant, the number 82 of Mike Parks, and a number 7 a Dipper Alsip. Laps to go in the 25-lap late model street feature event. Kenny Isomo steers the field down, and the green is out. Tom Carey Jr. beats Steve Gaynor to the turn to hold on to the lead position. Gray looks to make it three wide going into turns three and four. Daring move by Barry Gray, and it pays off as he's got the third spot. Ed Stone comes up from the back. On the low side, excuse me, of Dave Sutherland, and Stone has moved into fourth position. More three-wide action off of turn number four. Halfway point is coming up. 12 laps down, 13 to go for Tom Carey Jr. Carey leads, Gaynor runs second, Gray is third, Stone is fourth, Sutherland fifth. Drops down with the number 82 car. Stone goes to the outside of Gray. Yellow flag is out, and we have a wheel off of a car. Watch it in the infield. Heads up. The number 60 car, the Beckwith Automotive, number 60 of Jeff Beckwith, throws a wheel on the back stretch. And Tim Barocca, 11th, Doug Rudolph, and 12th, the number 85 of Kirby Monteith. Yellow flag comes out, green flag comes out as we come off of yellow. I get that right. And Steve Gaynor is coming on. Gaynor side by side with Tom Carey. Gives away to Carey and gives up the second spot to Barry Gray. Gaynor looks to tuck in the third position. Stone on the inside of Gaynor. And Stone moves into third, Gainer back to fourth, fifth spot is Sutherland. Two cars together and they're heading down towards pit road. Yellow flag comes out. Green. And we have it. As Carey breaking out on top, Barry Gray holding on to the second position, Ed Stone challenges with the number three. John Ledger comes on with car number 11. And it's Ledger side by side with Gainer. Ledger moves into fourth, Gainer back to fifth. Good action going on for position 6 through 10. And they are side by side down the length of the backstretch. Five laps to go this time around. Five to go as Ed Stone gets the measure of Gray at the line and takes over the second spot. Begins to surface with the 6 Connecticut. Two laps to go. It's still Carey on top, Stone running second, Gray third, Ledger fourth, Cross has moved into fifth. White flag, one lap. And the checkered flag waves. Here he comes. Tom Carey Jr. takes the win. Developing off of turn four. It's starting to resemble a demolition derby here. We've got Kevin Livingood going backwards.
Event Carnival 5 Junior, Tom Carey Jr. Second goes to the 3 of Ed Stone and third to the 2. 29 of Barry Gray.
Gary Jr. posing with his children for pictures from Bert Gould. Well, congratulations, Tom. You've had a couple of bad weeks here. You haven't found Victory Lane, various things going wrong with your racing efforts here, but you're back here in Victory Lane with us once again. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah, we lost Lady Luck there for a couple of weeks. The car was hooked up, but we just were at the wrong place at the right time. We smashed it pretty bad last week, but we worked on it all week, got it back together, and man, all I can thank is the crew and my sponsors, McKenney's Mobile, Dave Ray's Carriage Shop, all of them. Without them, we wouldn't be here, that's for sure.
Well, sure, the car ran like a bear, that's for sure, tonight there, and you seemed to come through the pack well. Once you were out ahead there, you seemed to have the power to be able to pull away, and it was a relatively comfortable run for you, despite all the yellow flags.
Yeah, the car's hooked up, but when it's going like that, you got to take advantage of it and get them in there while you can, because it don't go like this every week.
Okay, thank you very much, Tom, and a nice round of applause for your winner, Tom Carey Jr. Second place finisher, car number 3, Ed Stone. And third spot goes to number 29 for Barry Smokey Gray.
Riding out the field in the final row, car number 28 Mass will be Scooter Adams of Winterton, Massachusetts, and the 69 will be Mike Cole, a visitor, starting at the rear of the field. Here they come into turn number 3, looking for green. Kenny Icewell likes what he sees, and they're off and running. Off into the number 1 spot goes John Mallett, but we've got cars tangling down the back straightaway. Mallett leads down the front straightaway. Buffy Dix is second. Third is Parker, fourth is Ferry, and Wayne Chapin's looking good for 58 as he is part of a battle for the 7th spot with Bill Johnston. Johnston takes the spot away. Chapin gets way up high off the 4th turn. Mark Armentrout looks strong in the 22A. Here comes Johnston to the outside of Stymus. Carnival 74 looking for a way into the top 5. Turn number 4, John Corliss drops to the infield. Mike Cole receives the black flag, but we stand a green. Mallett leads. Buzzy Dix is second. Third is Parker. Fourth is Therian. Fifth is Simons. We've got trouble down the front straightaway as the 4X of Burgess makes contact with the wall. Johnston also making contact with the wall in car 74, and the yellow flag is out. 11. Johnston is hooked to the wall with car 74, trying to pull away as he is on the business end of our tow truck. So, tough night for Johnston. Rick Payne's running 6th, Dave Meany is 7th, Tom Stone 8th. Highlight with car number 97 as he is holding off Dix. So we see Kent Therian running in the 4th spot with car number 90. So he's having a fine run tonight. Here they come into turn number 3, Mallett, Buzzy Dix, Jason Parker, and Kent Therian are the highlights. We've got a green. Mallett leads. to the number four. Of Jason Parker, and rounding up the top five, the 97 of John Mellon.
Out this evening to racing here at Monadnock Speedway. We hope you enjoyed yourself and that you liked the racing action. If you did, we hope that you tell your friends so that they can come and enjoy all the excitement that happens here each and every Friday night at Monadnock Speedway at the High Banks Quarter Mile. Don't forget this coming Friday will be special family fun night and say no to drugs night. We hope you can make it. Special $6 admission price for adults and children 12 years of age and under admitted absolutely free. Hopefully you have a safe ride home. Obey those speed limits. This is Janet Burney, your track announcer. Thank you very much for coming out and being a part of the racing here at Monadnock Speedway. For those of you that are going to be sticking around, we will have the interview with Rick Payne. Of the season, a 25-lap strictly stock championship race. You got to be proud of your own efforts and the efforts of the crew who really have this car perking for you tonight.
Yeah, I never do good on these long races at this track. It's nice to have a long race and finally do good. As you know, we blew a motor last week. We worked hard all week long. We had a little trouble earlier today. We got everything together and the car went real well. It was a real good race.
Well, you couldn't have picked, like I said, a better one to have it all come true and everything gel together fine. How about a nice round of applause for our feature event winner of the 25-lap strictly stock championship race, Rick Payne Jr. Finishing second, the number 39 car, Tom Stone. And third position goes to the 15 Massachusetts of D.